and how to install Hudson. So introduction of all Hudson features and configuring the Hudson for projects and managing builds and how to install plugins in the Hudson and configuring security in the Hudson environment and monitoring external jobs. Okay, so coming to continuous integration. So what is continuous integration? So you all know what is build, right? Yeah, I will let you know what is the difference between Hudson and subversion. So before that, you just think about what is build. Build is a build is nothing but compiling of your sources into an distributable artifact. So people will be writing the source code. So it needs to be compiled and packaged so that it can be distributed to customers or users for using it. So this is the definition of the build. So normally this build might be happening. So after development, it can happen during development. So it can happen in a periodic basis, like every week or every month. So what continuous integration is? Continuous integration is nothing but a software development practice where members of each team integrate their work daily, that is more frequently. So as they integrate their work daily, so they can test it every day so that it reduces the problems and it can identify the problems earlier and you can fix it earlier so that you can make your product more stable. That is the main use of the continuous integration. So if you start building at the end of the project, you will see, you will identify so many issues. Those are integration issues because code will be developed by the multiple developers. So if you start integrating them daily, so you will identify the issues earlier and you can fix them earliest so that your code quality gets increased and you will not see any issues during release time. Is that clear? Okay, so if you are not understanding, you can just type in the chat so that I can answer. Okay. Yeah. So the prerequisites for this is you should have a project with your build script. So build script might be written in a AND build script, or it can be a batch file, or it can be a Maven project XML. So this is the pictorial representation of continuous integration. So multiple developers are working on the project. So SVN is the source code repository, so which keeps the versioning of your files and maintaining our file data. So Hudson is the continuous integration system which pulls your source repository like SVN and take the source code from the source repository and starts the build. So it will, the build script is provided in either AND build script or batch file or Maven build script. So it will execute that build script and it will generate the artifact. So artifact is nothing but the output of your source code. So after compiling and packaging your source code, your artifact will be generated. So once the artifact is generated from the given build script, so it can be given to the QA for validation. So if there are any automated tests, they can be run and the reports will be published from the Hudson dashboard. or continuous integration system dashboard. So the difference between SVN and Hudson is, so SVN will just keep track of your source code versioning, and Hudson will manage the running builds and managing your builds. So once you configure your project with the Hudson, so it will take care of building it whenever there are changes happened in your source code, and publish if there are any build failures or if there are any issues with the test cases. So as multiple developers working on the same source code, it's better to integrate daily so that you can identify any dependency issues or any other issues earliest. Is that clear? So the prerequisites for this is, so you should have knowledge on SVN, subversion, and build script. I think those two classes are over for you. Yeah. After that, so that is more or less introduction of the Hudson and how to install the Hudson. So you can, I have sent you this link. You can download this WAR file from this link, and you can start. So once, because this is a Java WAR file, you can deploy this WAR file in one of the application servers like Tomcat, WebLogic, WebSphere. So you can start it without application server also in a standalone mode using this command. So you need not install anything. You can just download this file and you can run this command and give the location of this file. So by default, this Hudson server will start on port number 8080. So if you wanted to change it to different port, so you can use this command. You can use the option --http port and you can give a different port number here. So once the, so when you give this command, the server will be started. Once it is started, so you can access the dashboard of the Hudson using the URL, your IP address and the port number on which your Hudson server is started. So that is this port number. So we will see the demo of this, how to start the server. So what are the main features that Hudson will provide? So you can download in any location. You can configure the projects in any of the locations in your system. So by default, Hudson will configure in a user's home directory. So if you wanted to store in a different location, so you can just specify a Hudson underscore home environment variable, so that it will configure all its jobs in the location provided in the Hudson home directory. So it will do continuous builds on your project and it fails fast. So whenever there are changes happen to the your source code in the SVN repository, so it will identify the changes and it will start building automatically. And it will send mail, notify via mail or RSS, so that they can immediately find the build failure in the system. And you can schedule the builds periodically also. Every day you can schedule, or every week you can schedule the builds. And you can view the change sets. Change set is nothing but what are the changes that were happened to the project from the previous build to the current build. So the advantage of change set is, suppose if there is a build failure, so you can view the changes that were happened from the last build to this build. So You can verify those changes which causes the build failure. And you can view the logs of the builds from browser. So when there is a build failure, you can view the build failed log from the browser. And you can view the history of the files modified also from the Hudson dashboard. And if you have any unit test cases, you can configure the reports with Hudson. So automated tests. So if your build script has the ability to run the test cases, Hudson has a reporting framework available. So when you give the executed reports to the Hudson server, so it will show it in the dashboard. And you can monitor the job that is running outside the Hudson. Suppose you can start a process outside the Hudson environment, and you can monitor the status of the process from the Hudson dashboard. So whether it is failed or success, or what is the status of the process, you can monitor from the dashboard. That is monitoring the executions externally. So these are the main features, and you can configure multiple nodes on the Hudson. So that is advanced session. So in this session, we will be covering these things. And in Hudson, everything is installed as a plugin. Each feature in the Hudson is installed as a plugin. Suppose in future, if you wanted to integrate with different version control system other than Subversion, like ClearCase or Perforce, so you need to install the plugin that supports the Perforce or ClearCase. So each feature in Hudson environment is delivered in the form of a plugin. So whenever there is a requirement comes in Hudson, so you need to check whether the related plugin is available or not. So if the plugin is available, you can just install the plugin and configure it. So how to install plugins and configuring plugins, you can we'll see in the next sessions. So these are all main features of the Hudson. So we will see a demo of each of these things. And from the system side, so till now we have discussed the features of that we can configure to the project. So from the Hudson side, so you can configure, it has a nice UI for configuring the properties of the system and setting up the authorization and authentication. So you know what is authentication and authorization. So authentication is nothing but providing access to the users. And authorization is nothing but once the access is provided, so which parts he can access and which parts he cannot access. So you can control the some parts in the authorization. So test case is nothing but a source code. Yeah, it's a there's a automated test case or manual test case. Two types are there. So manual test case is nothing but what needs to be verified when a requirement is given to you. So that is not part of a configuration management, but when you are using AntScript, or you can configure the test reports with the Hudson. Test case is nothing but verifying a piece of code. Yeah, managing nodes is like, suppose you can configure one Hudson server as a master server, and you can configure different. So if you are in a network, you can configure multiple Hudson servers, and you can make one server as a master server and all other servers as slaves, and you can distribute the jobs to the slave nodes. So that is managing nodes. So that is not in this session. So that's an advanced one. So we will not be covering in our session. and this is managing plugins. So as we discussed, each feature is delivered in Hudson as a plugin. And prepare for shutdown. So when there is a maintenance of the Hudson system, you cannot shut down it immediately. So you need to first stop starting builds. So then there are no builds are running. So you can do maintenance for shutdown. You can shut down for maintenance. So Hudson provides option for preparing shutdown so that it will not allow any other builds to happen. And if there is some build request comes, it will be queued. And once the Hudson server is made available, so the builds will be picked up from the queue and it will execute it. So is it clear till now? Yeah. So there are different types of projects that you can configure from Hudson. So creating a freestyle project means it's a normal AND project or batch script running. So there's a different project type called Maven. So it's altogether different. It has a different build script mechanism, different building mechanism apart from AND, and monitoring external jobs and configuring multi-configuration project. Multi-configuration project is nothing but suppose you have a project that needs to be built. So that needs to be built with a different environment or different configurations. Different environment means suppose your project needs to be built on Windows and Linux, or your project needs to be built with multiple versions of Java or multiple versions of AND. So you can have multiple artifacts based on the configuration. So you can configure a project with multiple configurations. So in that case, we will use configure multi-project job. So the actions that you can do is you can run builds and you can view the change sets. So you all know what is change set, and you can download the artifacts directly from the dashboard. So once the build is successful, the artifact should be available on the dashboard for downloading. And you can view the build trends, what are the builds failed, what are the past builds that were failed, and what are the builds that is success. Yeah, artifact is nothing but the output of your project build. So once your source code is built and packaged, so that is called artifact. Output of your source code. And tagging builds. So once the build is made for release, you can tag it in the subversion. So this is about how to execute monitoring external jobs, and you can have installing and updating and uninstalling plugins. So yeah, as we see that this what is authentication and authorization. The running builds is a development practice. In production, you will not do any kind of builds. So build is pure development practice for generating output of your source code. Yeah. So authentication is nothing but you know, right, providing access to the users and setting permissions for the user actions, and it has a project level security also. So you can do certain actions at project and you cannot do certain actions. So you can project, you can configure a project level authorizations. Yeah, these all we are going to see in our Hudson sessions. So this is more theory and presentation part. So we will go to demo now. So till now, are there any questions or is that clear? Yeah. What is the? So the use of build script is suppose you have a source code. So your source code might be contain different types of files. Suppose if it is a web application, your source code will be containing Java source files and there are some web application files. So you need to compile the Java source files and you need to pack the web files and you need to make all of them as a zip and you need to distribute it. So you cannot give directly your source code to customers or users. So it needs to be compiled to a format so where which can be installed on the customer systems. So for preparing the compiled output or for preparing the deliverable or installer, so you need to have a build script which will do that. You cannot manually compile the whole source code of so number of developers that they are developing, and you cannot do it manually every day. So if you have a script for building a source code, you can just execute the build script every day. Yeah, we will discuss that in summary after the session is over. Because you just had a theory part, once you have a demo, so you will get more knowledge, then we will discuss about in summary what are the activities that you will encounter in a day-to-day business. Okay, I have downloaded the WAR file. So I have downloaded the WAR file from the link that was given to you. And I have a sample project that I have already sent you in the mail. So you can come in. So for before the configuring Hudson server, the project should be available in one of the source control systems like Subversion. So I have committed this project to the my Visual SVN and checked out the project, and I have a build script. So this is my source code. My source code contains some Java files. And some test cases. So these are the automated test cases for testing my source code. And I have a build script. So what is my build script contains? So you all know AND, right? How to write AND script. Okay. My build script has a default target. So it will call different targets based on the parameter that I passed. So if I pass voice name Windows, it will call target Windows. And it depends on different other targets. Clean, compile and all. So clean will delete my build folders and then it will compile my Java source code using this Java C task. And it will compile my test source code using Java C. And it will execute the unit tests using JUnit task. And finally it will run the jar target and it will package the Java compiled output into a jar file. So this is the output art, this jar file is the output artifact of my project. So which will contain all my compiled output. So once for our project the build script is ready, so you need to manually verify whether the build script is proper or not, whether it is executing properly and generating artifacts. So I am calling my build script with the target windows. Sorry, I think and is not available. So and is not available in my path. I am setting and. So my build.xml is inside folder Hudson demo. Now the build script is executing, so it is compiling all the source files and it will prepare the output jar file. So jar file is my artifact. It has compiled and the build is successful. So it has created this folder and the compiled classes are here and they are packaged into jar file. And compiled the test classes and the executed test results are available as an XML files. So this is my test result files. So they are available in this format. So Hudson will provide you a nice reporting on this generated test results. So how to configure the test results we will see. Now the build script is executed. And it has generated the artifact connect4.jar. This is my artifact of the artifact of my project. So now my build script is working fine and my project is commit available in the subversion. This Hudson demo is the project and I have committed the project in the subversion and it is available and my build script is working fine. Now it is ready for configuring in Hudson configuring continuous integration. Yeah, we will discuss about that day-to-day tasks once the session is over. So that is altogether a different discussion. So related to your tasks. Is that clear about the build script? So ideally, the build script is available for you when you are asked to configure this in the Hudson. So is that clear? What is the build script and what are the prerequisites? Yeah, can you type in what is not clear? Yeah, build script should be written manually. It is not gets generated automatically. I think in our YANT session, so you would have had a session on how to write build scripts and how to run the build scripts. The YANT session is already over, right? So this is just a prerequisites that I am showing before configuring continuous integration. So you will have a source code, so which needs to be committed to the Subversion server. So you have a SVN session, you know how to make the project commit to SVN server and doing checkouts and check-ins and everything. And after that you will know how to write a build script. So normally in most cases you will not be writing the build script, so that would be already available if it is a project that is a new project that is getting starting, and if it is entirely new, in that case only we have to write the build script. Otherwise the build scripts would be will be available already. So you need to just, I am showing because we are configuring this AND project for continuous integration in Hudson, I am explaining you the build script that we are using in our project. So build script can be written in multiple ways. So this here we are writing the build script in AND. So build script can be written using batch files or shell files in Linux, and it can be written using maven pom.xmls. So that's a different way of building using maven. So for once you have a build script is available, then you can configure the project in Hudson for continuous integration. If you don't have a build script, you cannot configure it in Hudson for continuous integration. Is that clear? Okay, I will delete this repository and I will show you how to commit. Okay, I have deleted everything. So I will commit the project now. So before committing project in my SVN, I should have a repository. Selecting create default structure, which will create trunk branches and tags. And once the repository is created, I will give permissions. So I have given permissions to the user. So if the user is not already exist, you can just create the user and give the permissions. So you all know, right, how to install this Visual SVN server and creating repository and creating a project. And copy the trunk URL and check out it. So this is my new URL, demo project slash trunk. So you take SVN checkout and paste the URL and it will be checked out. So this is my location of the trunk. So it doesn't have any files. I checked out this, copied the URL and checked out. I did SVN checkout and provided the URL that I have copied. And extract the given zip file. To your checked out location. FHD demo project. So I have extracted the files in given in the zip file. And add all these files to SVN and commit. Right click data as SVN, add, select everything and do data as SVN add. And then do SVN commit. It's committed. So my source code is available now in Subversion and I have a build script so that it is ready for setting up continuous integration with Hudson. Is that clear? Okay. So now we will see how to start Hudson server and viewing dashboard. So this is the WAR file that I have downloaded and I have kept in location my F drive and HD folder. So go to the command prompt. So wherever Hudson WAR file is available and type command. So java hyphen jar WAR file and just press enter. So by default the Hudson will start on port 8080. So if you wanted to change it to different port, so you have to use the option hyphen hyphen HTTP port. So once the Hudson server is started successfully, you will see the message like Hudson is ready. So once the server is started, you can view the dashboard, HTTP and IP address of your machine, or you can use this 127.0.0.1 is the IP address of localhost, so which is valid for any machine, and the port number that the Hudson server started, that is 8080. So if the Hudson WAR file is deployed in one of the application server, so the URL will be different, the access URL, because it started in a standalone mode, the URL is this. So if it is started in if it is deployed in one of the application servers, so you need to type in the URL of the application server, and then slash Hudson you have to type in, so that URL will be given to you in your company. This is the dashboard of the Hudson, and it has the left side menu, so creating new job and so manage Hudson. So this manage Hudson section contains more of system related information rather than project, like what are the system properties and how to install and manage plugins and how to manage nodes and how to preparing the system for shutdown. So more or most of administration related activities will be given in this manage Hudson section, and configuring a project and everything will be come from this new job section, and this build history shows the previous builds, and this people section will show who are all the people have access to this Hudson environment. Yep. So that's it for today's session. So we will see how to configure the project. And other activities in the next session tomorrow same time. So is there any other questions related to the session today? So you can practice. I have shared already with you the presentation and the sample project and the URL from which you can download the Hudson WAR file, and you can practice it. So the link, Niranjan would have shared you the Dropbox link. So it's already containing the videos of the Hudson. So you can go through it and you can try to practice it. Yeah, the video is available in Dropbox. So Jenkins is same as Hudson, there are no differences. It's just a rename. Yeah, cruise control is altogether a different version control continuous integration system. Yeah, that you need to have a separate, if you have a requirement, you need to have a separate session for that cruise control. So that is not covered in this part. This is just specific to Hudson session. Yeah, you cannot use Yandt. You can use and to run Hudson WAR file, but that is not required, right? You can directly type in Java command. So why you wanted to run Hudson WAR file from Yandt? Yeah, you can you need not extract the WAR file, you can just download and you can run it. Not this exactly this lecture in the Dropbox. The earlier sessions that we had with the different teams is placed in the Dropbox. So they are more or less same. So you can access it from there. Yeah, port number is 8080. By default, it will start on 8080. So it was given in the PPT. Installing Hudson. In PPT, you have a session installing Hudson. Slide in with name installing Hudson. You can view it there. Link was given in the mail.